Hey everyone, this is Evan with Johnson Plastics. I'm here with my friend Caitlin, and we are here to talk to you about the FLUX line of lasers and specifically what an asset they can be in the classroom of an educator.
So we've got some really cool stuff here to show you today, but first we're going to have George run through some housekeeping things so that you guys can make sure that the audio is working and the video, and he'll cover that for us.
Yeah, thanks Caitlin. So welcome everyone to our webinar. We're glad that you could stop by today. A couple of quick housekeeping technical items. On the right hand side of your screen, you should see a place where you can ask questions. Type those in. We'll have some folks offline answering them, and we'll also answer some online during the webinar as well. If for some reason at some point you have trouble hearing the audio through your computer speakers, there is a dial-in number that sometimes works a little better. Depending on how many attendees we have, we tend to tie up some of the bandwidth, so try and give that number a call if you're having trouble hearing. We will have some close-up cameras today. We'll be getting in so you'll be able to see the laser in action and some other equipment as well. But please ask questions, and also at the end of the webinar, tomorrow you will get an email that will have a link to the recording of this webinar, so if you want to go back and watch anything, you'll have that ability as well. So without further ado, Evan, Caitlin, let's see some lasers.
Great. Thank you, George, and thank you everyone for joining us today. So. Again, we're talking about what an asset the FLUX line of lasers can be for an educator. I think a lot of people tend to gravitate specifically to what it can do maybe for your STEM program, and it is a great asset to your STEM program, but Caitlin has some really awesome examples that she spent a lot of time putting together as to how that laser can be an asset and help really bring home other subjects for your students as well using the FLUX laser and the accompanying materials that we have. Do you want to kick it off?
Yeah, so first let's talk about what FLUX lasers we carry here at Johnson Plastics Plus. So we do have four lasers available to purchase. They range in size, but for the most part, if you can see behind us, they are all desktop laser size. So they don't take up a ton of room. You don't need a special building to put it in. They do have a built-in exhaust system that you can hook up to an air filtration unit. So we have with us here today, this is the FLUX Hexa. It is a 60 watt laser, and we have it hooked up to, it actually a BOFA unit today, but FLUX does carry what they call the beam air filtration. And what that does is it actually pulls the harmful smells and the harmful chemicals that you get when sometimes cutting materials out through the back of the laser, and it puts it into the filtration device so that you're not smelling that, you're not breathing that stuff in. And that's one of the great assets of these lasers and why they are a great tool to add to a classroom. We also do carry three other lasers that we couldn't show all today. We have the FLUX BMO, which is a 30 watt laser. And then we also have the FLUX Beam Box, which is a 40 watt laser, just slightly bigger than the BMO. And then we have the FLUX Beam Box Pro, which is a 50 watt laser. Yes. That was a lot of information to rattle off there.
Yes.
So yeah, they all come with some really great safety features. Evan, do you want to touch on some of those?
Yeah, I can actually touch on that. So as far as safety goes, there are a decent amount of lasers out there in the world that kind of use an open architecture and, you know, as kind of a cost savings measure. And really, it's not something that you necessarily want in a classroom environment, right? Because you have children there, you want to have a way to exhaust the fumes away from it. You don't want a way for little hands or eyes to be anywhere near the laser,
yeah.
Which is why the enclosed design of the FLUX series, all of them are this way, are completely enclosed, exhaust goes out the back, this clear glass cap here, so that it allows you to see what's going on in the laser, which I'm sure kids would be really excited to watch.
Yeah, they're gonna have their noses up to that.
Yeah, exactly, but it's completely safe. All the laser cutting and fumes are going on inside. If you were to open this, while the laser is running, it will actually shut everything off.
Yes.
So that makes it a safe utility to have access to in your classroom. Something that is a really good fit for that type of environment compared to some of the other open architecture hobby lasers that exist.
Yep. And then it also comes with a really easy to use software called Beam Studio, and that you can load onto an Apple computer or a PC, and you can take artwork design files and import it in and then send it directly to the laser. So it's very easy to use, user friendly, And that does come with the laser. You don't have to make an additional purchase. It's all part of the package when you purchase a Flux laser.
Yep, and then I would say another asset for choosing this type of machine, and specifically from Johnson Plastics, we do have our own support here, our advanced support team, full of very competent and qualified experts that will help you with a remote installation for the machine, as well as giving you the tips and tricks that you need to set it up and succeed with that machine.
So at Johnson Plastics Plus, I'm sure you all are wondering, what materials can you put in this laser? So everything we sell on our website is tested to be safe in the laser. So we, our advanced support team, they, when we bring in a new material, they put it into the lasers, make sure that it is easy to cut. We provide tech docs and settings, or starting tech settings for the laser, recommended settings for you to use. So you don't have to worry about when you're coming to our site, like, is this okay to actually put in our laser? We've already done that work for you. So you can just be have the peace of mind knowing that when you purchase from us, that, that all your materials are safe and easy to use.
And you kind of answered the question we had come in offline, Caitlin. It was about what materials are safe to use in the laser. And again, on our website, look for the little lightning bolt. That little icon will let you know that that has been tested and safe for laser engraving.
Yep.
If it's got a lightning bolt, it works.
Yep, exactly. There are some rotary-only materials that we carry for the rotary sign makers in the world, but anything that's got that lightning bolt laser symbol on it material-wise is going to be completely safe to use in any of the Flux lasers.
Evan, Caitlin, could you speak to why what may happen if you put some non laser safe items in a laser?
Sure, yeah. So best case scenario, you're going to get some really obnoxious fumes, and you may get some flaming up from the laser as it's cutting the material. The material is going to get very melty. It's going to smell really, really bad. It can be a safety concern as well, because some of those materials can be a fire hazard if they're not laser safe. So utilizing materials that are specifically marked as laser safe on our website, and everything that we're going to show you here today is what you're going to want to keep to put into that machine.
So let's jump in and show you some of the items that we have created here that can be added to your curriculum. So the first item here I'm going to show off is for language arts. In this here, we've created, I'll do it on the close-up here. So the lesson plan here would be that the kids would write their own short story, and they would create their own fictional character here. And then in addition to that, they could then design their own book cover, and they would be required to, or limited to, using only 3 colors. And then what we would have them do is then use our stamp material here. So they would design their character, import that design into our laser using our laser safe rubber here. So they'd have to cut out 3 different pieces for each color. So what the laser does is it removes the material not needed and leaves behind the design. So we've got the blue here. Then we've got the pink that we used, and then the purple for the horse's body. And then they would then apply a stamp, ink, or paint, and then layer it on top of their book cover. So this teaches the kids how to think creatively, then use problem solving skills to decide how they can only use 3 colors to create their character. And then it just really brings their story to life. And I have a piece of stamp material, what it looks like before it's put into the laser. So again, we have the settings for this on our site under our Tech Docs tab, and there's starting settings so that you can test your material in there before you get started.
Awesome. I love how those, you know, 3 colors come together to create a character, and you know, it just kind of helps bring their story to life a little bit more. That's really a really neat use of it, for sure. So I'll cover one here, actually. So the next one I wanted to talk about, we have for science and history, we have this awesome T-Rex here, and I'll pass it over to her in a moment for the close-up. But this is actually cut from a plywood material, a very special plywood material that we offer, called the Romark Color Shop Woods. And the Color Shop Woods line is basically a pre-stained finish plywood product that is laser safe. It comes in a whole slew of colors. And Caitlin has this awesome design where you can actually see multiple pieces of flat sheet stock come together to create this three-dimensional dinosaur. What a neat way to kind of, you know, bring home some ideas about history and, you know, archaeology or whatever you want to touch on with that. There's a lot of different characters or animals that you could fabricate that way. And there's a wide range of colors, and you could even mix and match the various colors depending on the type of creature that you're making. So Caitlin's going to show the Color Shop Woods line jump chain. I just want you guys to get an idea for how many different ones there are.
There's so many. I can't.
Oh, blues, purple, pink, yellow, green, red. Go for it, George.
So question that came in for the teachers out there wanted to know, where do they get the files to make that really cool dinosaur? Because you don't need to be a designer to create these to have these files for your students in the classroom.
Yep.
So there are a lot of great free options out there. But the great thing about FLUX is they are actually building up their curriculum that they offer on their website. So it's not quite live yet, but it is something that they're working towards. So they will have some curriculum files for teachers to be able to go in and download. And that would include they're called SVG or PDF files for you to import into the Beam Studio software. But there is a ton of free resources out there. And the beauty of the laser is, and part of the learning is for the kids to learn how to build this themselves. So in this example with the dinosaur, that may be a little bit harder for them to do, and downloading a file would be an easier option. But we do have some other examples here to show you where they can actually use their full creativity and problem solving skills to design the entire piece. So we do have some great pieces like that to show
on,
you.
On that note for like free files and resources for it, a lot of websites that carry like 3D printer files also have a laser files section. So there's options, there's one called Fangs, there's Thingiverse, there's others out there that people will take things that they've designed and share it publicly, oftentimes for little or no cost whatsoever. So there's a lot of free resources out there to be had for these types of things.
And there is also paid resources as well. I know Etsy does carry a lot of design files that you can download, and they're only a couple of dollars, and you can just keep using those files over and over and over again.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, so that is a great enhancement to, you know, your science, your history, your archaeology, maybe geology. There's a lot of different ways you could integrate that product into a lesson plan for sure.
So I will show off this next piece we have here.
You had me want to talk about this because
I
took
one
look at it. I'm like, this is the coolest thing ever, but I want you to cover it because there's so much that went into it.
So what we've created here is a human anatomy puzzle, and it's pretty interactive. So they would remove this top cover piece, and then each layer here contains different puzzle pieces of the body. So here we have the muscle. So this body is actually removable, so they could take that in or out. And then these pieces here, the pectoral and the abdomen here, can be removed and then put into the puzzle. So the abdomen and the pectorals here were made out of cast acrylic. We engraved away some of the material here, which is where it's a little bit of a faded look here on top. And then you can see the bright, vibrant orange underneath. So the next layer here is the skeleton. And this is some of my favorite material here that we used. It is our Color Hues glitter. So we use the glitter material to make the different bone pieces here. So we've got the ribs and the spine, and that will slide right into the puzzle. Then we've got the pelvis here. Oops, I'm doing this backwards, so bear with me. I do know how to put this together, and then we have the skull as well. So the outer shell of this and the puzzle pieces are all made out of our plywood material. And then on the back side of this, if I can flip it over without losing everything, we have a veneer, a maple veneer. Used, and that's a very thin material just to keep the pieces from falling out when you're moving to the next one here. Yeah.
And there's a lot of different wood plywood products on our website. We did already mention the Color Shop woods, but there's some more basic and economical options like Baltic birch and walnut ply, and a lot of those different choices on there that you could use to make this type of product.
That's right. So another puzzle piece here, we've got the organs. And this is a really cool material here that we use to actually make the lungs. And I'm not sure how well it shows on the camera, but this is our cast acrylic and it is fluorescent. And that actually has a little bit of an edge glow to it. So it is a really cool material. And I think Evan, I put a piece over there in green.
Yep.
So that maybe they can see how cool that material is on the camera.
That's awesome.
You can actually see it here.
Oh yeah, that shows up
on
really
my
well.
Black shirt. You can see the edge glow here. So this is our fluorescent cast acrylic, and it is a very cool, very versatile material.
There, it pops up even better now. Yep. This stuff glows very brightly.
Yeah.
it's
so we do
electric.
Have this in multiple colors. The green and the fluorescent pink is just one of the options that we carry.
And we have a lot of those different cast and translucent and opaque acrylic materials on jbplus.com. And we even, if you're making like small parts like that, we even sell them in like 5x10. So if you don't need huge quantities of it and you want to mix and match a bunch of colors, you can do that.
So all the pieces in here were made with cast acrylic. We've just got a variety. We've got the fluorescent for the lungs and the stomach and spleen. And then the intestines is made out of our glitter again. So we've got one more puzzle piece underneath here. If I can get it out. My finger is just meant for a child, so my fingers are a little too big. But so the last piece here is another organs puzzle here. So we've got the heart made out of red cast acrylic. And then the bladder, which is our glitter material again. And the liver, which is orange cast acrylic. Pancreas is the fluorescent material. These pieces are very tiny, so hopefully they're coming through on the camera. And then the brain. We've done some engraving here, so you can see the brain lines. On that fluorescent material, which really makes it pop.
A quick note on that too, you may see these buzzwords thrown around on our website and webinars. You may hear us talk about vector and rastering.
Yes.
Vector is a through cut all the way through the material, so that's how we're cutting it out to shape. Rastering is using the laser to kind of just rough up the surface of the material so you get that frosty contrast. And a lot of those pieces that you're seeing there, Caitlin obviously cut it to shape, but then also use the rastering to kind of add some contrast to make things stand out a little bit better. So if you hear those words thrown around, that's what they mean.
And then you also can, there's different, and this is a good piece to show the example. You can do your engraving at different depths. So you can see his hair is lighter color than his skin, and that was just, we set the engraving at a different power so that it would engrave a little bit deeper, so that there's a little bit of color variation, so you can see the difference between his hair and his skin there.
Awesome. That's the best piece sitting here today.
So lots of flexibility with the laser. You can do all kinds of unique projects.
Yeah, absolutely. So the next thing that I wanted to cover, music, history, a lot of different applications for this one. We have this lovely drum here that Caitlin designed. And so this is made out of the Saddle Collection faux leather material that we offer on our website. It is sold in sheet form like this. These are very economical. These are like under $4 for a 12x24 sheet. And it looks so neat when it's engraved. If you want to show that off. So basically the laser was used to do a couple things here. It was used to actually cut out the Saddle Collection into a circle. Did you use it to make the holes too?
Yeah.
Could use it to make the holes?
I had to punch some extra holes in, but
okay. Fair enough.
I underestimated how many holes I was trying to use.
And then the other thing too, the design on the front, you can have the kids actually design their own thing to put on the front of it, and that black area that was engraved, that is how the Saddle Collection responds when it gets hit by the laser without cutting all the way through. So when you raster across the top, you get that high contrast black underneath it that comes through on your design when it's been lasered. So a lot of different options that you can do with the salad collection material and could be incorporated into a lot of different subject matters inside your class.
That's a good example of problem solving for the kids, that they have to figure out how to sew up the drum so that when they use their mallet, or I'm not sure what the
correct, call it a drumstick today.
Their drumstick to hit the drum, that it actually makes noise and bounces off the strings in the back. So it's a great project for them to use. It could be done as a group activity or solo activity where they have to problem solve how to make the drum actually make noise.
I love it. That's a really, really creative design too. Is that a, just so I know too, the inside like hoop, is that like something you can get from like a craft store or what's,
yeah,
how did you work that out?
It's actually an embroidery hoop or a macrame hoop. So I just bought it from the local craft store here and hope that it works. So I use my problem solving skills too to design this project.
Considering some of the macrame I've seen you work into some of our other projects, I feel like you probably have a stash of those already.
I do, yeah, for sure.
Good deal. So I think the next one actually is this one, and I'm going to be really careful with this. So, science, we have a really neat rocket ship that is designed out of the Baltic birch material, or really any plywood, which, as I mentioned, we have quite a few. You want to put that on the close-up?
Of course.
Yeah, so kind of a similar idea to the dinosaur. You can kind of use your problem-solving skills here a little bit to figure out how all these pieces go together. How do you take, 25 puzzle pieces and turn them into a cohesive and finished project. Very hands-on, it's kind of goes together like a puzzle with some glue, and you end up with this really neat model rocket that you can incorporate into your science lesson.
And then in addition to just putting it together, they could also create their custom rocket design. So they could, this is an unfinished material, so it can be painted, so they could put their own rocket design on here as well.
Yep, it could be painted. You can mix and match various colors of sheet material to make different contrasts and different colored panels as well.
So we had a question come in, and I know we kind of addressed it earlier, but just had somebody pop into the webinar and wanted to know, they love the drum, the drum design. Is that file available somewhere that they can get?
I can, so we can make it available. It's not currently right now. We're actually working on building a landing page for all of our artwork files. We're very close to launching that, so that would be included on that page.
Great. But you could also, once you have an idea, I mean, this thing's probably, what, 8 inches across, 9 inches across, whatever
eight
the size
inches,
of that hoop was.
Yeah.
You could also, even in lieu of that file, maybe have the kids take a drawing of their own, which you're gonna see more of that here in a little bit. Yes, I'm teasing the live demonstration
a little bit,
but you could take their own drawing and turn it into the design on the drum too. So there's an opportunity to make it even more, get them really invested in it,
That's a great idea.
So, yeah, and again, this is from a plywood product, the rocket, and it actually starts out looking very much just like this plain plywood sheet. That's how it starts, and this is what you end up with a little bit of design knowledge or a design file, the Flux line of lasers, and a little bit of glue. So, I think we're doing the live demo last, right? So we still want to cover.
Yep. Got a couple more things on the
table
here to cover. So the next item here I'm going to show off is another example of our saddle collection. We are not just limited to sheet material, but we also have some blanks or other items available. And this example here is actually a notebook. So when you're teaching during science class or geography, all about sea life, they could be journaling what they're learning and putting it into the saddle collection notebook.
Yeah, how neat would it be if you're as part of a creative writing class or literature or English, if you had a personalized, journal that you could do all your journaling in, and it would have their name or something that they designed that's engraved right on the front for them. Pretty cool.
So very cool. And we've got a lot of different products available. We've got some coasters, keychains in the saddle collection material.
Absolutely. And then another one to cover, think of this as like classroom assets, and this could be part of a learning experience as well. Caitlin designed these lovely locker tags. This is, you could make these out of a lot of different things. This specifically is the Romark Laser Gloss Exterior. It's a really bright, shiny plastic. two-ply material. So you've got a white base or and then you have your color background on the face there.
And it is glossy, like Evan said, so it's easy to clean off. I know hygiene and cleanliness is really important in schools when you're trying to keep everybody there and healthy. So these can be easily wiped off. The white's not going to come off. It is, so what you're doing is engraving away that cap color. So the white is permanent. It's not going anywhere. So it is a great option to add for locker tags, cubby tags, anywhere that you might need to put a name or a child's name on something.
Yep, and it's guaranteed, as long as it stays stuck to its position, it's guaranteed to last the school year. You're not going to wipe it or fade it away with cleaning products. So,
and that does come in a variety of colors. It's not just limited to blue and orange. You could do your school colors. There's, I believe, 7 or 8 total colors in that line.
Yep.
But we do have a lot of other material that's similar to that that would work.
Yeah, absolutely. The next one was the memory game, I think.
Okay. So this next piece here, get out of the bag here, without throwing everything. So what we created here using our solid wood sheet is a bug matching memory game. So you could create this as a resource in your classroom for the kids to learn the different bugs in a game form here. So we've got all the different bugs here and then their names. But you could really make a memory game or any type of game out of any of the wood sheet materials we carry. I'm throwing everything. So really cool, the contrast there.
I think a really important part of this too is like a lot of this stuff is, the material is, it's very low cost. I mean, that depends on which wood sheet you use, but some of these are like under $10 for an entire sheet. That's 12 by 24, and you could probably make 2 or 3 of those matching games out of one sheet. And then the I do like these. This is another item we sell. This is a faux burlap material with a drawstring pouch on it, so you could use that to help keep your pieces organized. So
we got one more over there, the clear acrylic.
Oh, yeah,
I almost missed it on the table. Can't see it.
Yeah. It's clear in my defense. Well, here, let me draw something on it. So this is a clear acrylic piece that kids can use as a aid to learn how to form their letters. I drew on it just so you could see it because it is very clear. So this is a clear cast acrylic material, 1/8 thick. It has the letters engraved as a trace line on the back, which you can see where I traced over with the Expo marker there. And so that can be used as a reusable aid for much younger kids to learn, you know, the best way to form
their
letters.
And we personalized ours. We put, you know, the name Alex on the top here, but it really could be any, you could put numbers, letters, shapes on this. And this was actually reverse engraved, which means that we engraved on the backside of the material so that the front was completely smooth, so that it would easily clean off.
Yep. Easy to wipe off and and have them reuse it, which is awesome. So, but yeah, you could personalize it to a student so everyone's accountable for theirs, or you could have a stack of these that you hand out during lesson time for them to, you know, learn how to properly form their letters or shapes.
So I think we got one more surprise over there that we forgot to talk about.
This one or this one?
The rotary attachment,
okay.
And then let's do the demo. Okay. Show everyone how the laser works.
These things are so versatile, it's almost hard to keep track of all the different things. So this contraption sitting in front of me here, and we're going to show you how to run the laser a bit on a flat sheet material product here. But I did want to talk about this because I've personally engaged with a lot of schools that are looking this, especially for the older students, maybe on the STEM side or whatever, as a way to produce some school spirit materials, things that are can be used as a fundraiser to help fund certain events at the school. So this is a rotary attachment. And what this is designed to do is to insert into any of the FLUX lasers, where you can take a round engraving tumbler like this one. And if you've never seen this done before, we do have a video of it that will take you through the entire process. But the gist of it is the laser only really wants to move this way because you have a round, you know, uneven surface there. So the laser moves back and forth this way while the rotary attachment is slowly incrementally spinning the drinkware around so that you end up with your finished design. And this is designed to sit inside the laser bed, and there's just one cable to connect, and we even have a video that tells you how to connect that cable.
Sure do. Yeah.
So, and that is the rotary attachment. Again, think about, you know, these blanks are, you know, around $10 or so, depending on which one you pick. But this is something that you could pick up a case of these, sell them as a fundraising item for the school, put your logo, put your team, put your kids' jersey number on there,
sell
it for 20, 25 bucks, and make some money to help support events at the school. So that is the rotary attachment. Those are available for the FLUX lasers. Yes, George.
Yeah, we got a question came in, and it's a really good question. Andrew piped in and said this would be great for engineering and making 3D drawings. Can this be used with any 3D printed ABS or PLA plastic?
Yeah, you would not want to use anything ABS or PLA in here. Neither of those are laser safe. They tend to give off some noxious fumes when lasered. So I would steer clear of those. I would look at this as an enhancement to what you're already doing with 3D printing. You have additive manufacturing technology that you can demonstrate and teach your engineering students. And then now you have a way to do subtractive manufacturing that you can teach them. So I would say that it's an enhancement that is maybe complementary, but I wouldn't take those 3D print plastics and polymers and put them in the laser.
And if you're looking at a colored ABS sheet to do, you don't want to do that in laser, but there's usually an acrylic equivalent material that you
would use. Yep, exactly. And pretty much anything acrylic is going to be safe in the laser, but to stay on the safe side, if you're ordering from our website, we'll have that little laser compatible lightning bolt indicator for you to know that you're making the right material choice for your machine. Cool. So I think next up we have the demonstration, correct?
Yeah.
I've been hyped for this one all day.
So I'll
let you explain the background.
Yeah. So what we're going to be making here is we've had Holt, which is one of the sons here, create a character. So he created us a princess, and then we actually scanned it in and resized it to be the size of the keychain. So we're going to show you how we're going to make that keychain here on the laser. Right now.
Okay, great. So what we're going to do now, we do have a sheet of material that we're going to go ahead and place inside. Specifically, this product is a sublimation acrylic. We're going to talk to you more about what sublimation is when we get to that part, but again, it is an acrylic-based product. So that is going to go inside the laser bed. And does it usually pop up on its own?
It's on, yeah.
There we go. Cool. Position it right.
Yep.
Okay. So we're going to drag the laser head into position here. Autofocus, right?
Yep.
Okay.
So the
now go. So the a big asset that this machine has that you will not find on every laser is the autofocus. I think
we're both so excited about it. We want to.
Yeah, because there's a lot of machines out there that you have to do this autofocus part as a manual process, and you have to, you know, set the distance between the laser head and the material to make sure that you get a proper engraving. And this one takes care of it for you by pressing a button. Couldn't be easier.
So another really cool feature on this laser is it does have a built-in camera. So what that means is it doesn't matter where you put the material in the bed. I can take a picture of the bed and then place my artwork on top where I want it. So we're going to show you how that works here real quick.
Yep, so the camera is mounted there on the head, and when she starts that process, it's going to move that head around on the grid and start taking a photo of the material underneath it. So it's zeroing itself right now, and now it's going to start running around and taking photos. That does take a little bit of time to execute, so I will mention when we actually run this job, I will tell you the noise may kick up a little bit, and that is because of this filtration unit that's standing behind me. We touched on that a little bit at the beginning, but it's worth repeating. Basically what that does, instead of having to find an exterior wall to actually vent the gases out of the laser, this allows you to have the entire unit housed indoors. So that contains a HEPA filter inside of it so that any of the gases or things coming out of the laser are completely filtered by that unit and then safe to be in the room. There is a tiny bit of odor that you can notice,
yeah,
but
it depends on the material.
It depends on the material. Yeah. The wood just kind of smells vaguely like a campfire.
Yeah, it's kind of nice.
Yeah, it's actually rather pleasant.
Yeah, I don't mind it at all.
Yeah, so, but that makes it everything at a safe level for your classroom environment.
So it is done taking the photo here, so we're just going to move that up out of the way. You don't really have to do that. It's just habit for me to move that out of the way. And then Evan's closing the lid. And I've already imported our artwork into the Beam Studio software to cut out the keychain. So I'm going to send that job to the laser. And Evan is going to turn on that filter unit over there for us.
Wait, you guys threw me off. This is a different one that I used.
It's on the back. It's on the switch.
Thanks.
Yeah. All right, so you're hearing that that air filtration start up, and the laser is going to start cutting our princess shape that we're going to be then sublimating Holt's artwork onto.
How cool would that be as a kid, though, to like draw something like that and then have it like immortalized forever on a piece of plastic?
Really cool.
You know, that's pretty cool. So right now you're seeing how we get it cut to shape. Next, after this is done, you'll get to see how we add color to it, and that's another fun process.
Looks like we have a question.
I have a question, and it's a bit of a loaded question, but I'm going to ask it anyway. Somebody asked how long the filters last.
Usage. It depends on how often you're using it, what type of material you're cutting. If you're cutting something like this rubber sheet, you might need to change your filter a little bit more often, just because it does create a little bit of debris in the laser because it's removing so much material. But if you're just cutting a cast acrylic every once in a while, again, that filter is going to last a really long time.
Yep. And to think of it somewhat like a furnace. House.
Yeah.
The main machine itself is going to last a long time, as long as I have people kicking it, knocking it over in the classroom, the cabinet, so you're going to replace the actual filter in and out of the unit on a somewhat regular.
Yeah, from what I remember, it even kind of looks like an elaborate furnace filter. That's pretty much what it's doing. It's a similar concept there, but it's just forcing that air through that to where it can, you know, be safe to breathe again.
One of the other maintenance items on these lasers is the laser tube. So you can't see it here, it's actually hidden behind the housing, but it is a glass tube, and that only lasts for so many hours of laser engraving, so that is something that would need replaced, depending on your usage again.
Yeah, I think that it really does depend heavily on it, but I think most people report somewhere around like 1 to 3 years, kind of depending on how much it's utilized. And when it's starting to get bad, you will typically notice that, hey, I'm not quite getting all the way through material that I could get through before. I'm having to turn my power up or, you know, do multiple passes. So that's kind of your indicator that it's time for that part to be changed.
So another question that came in was about the software that comes with the FLUX line. I know we didn't have a close-up on your laptop, but we do have a video on our YouTube channel that shows you, look, if I can do it, you all certainly can do it.
It's very
easy.
It is really easy. FLUX did a great job developing the software where you can drag and drop the actual icon for the camera. It looks like a camera, so they've made that super user-friendly. You just drag and drop that on your workboard. And then to import artwork, it's actually the typical like photo icon that a lot of companies use. You click that and you just upload your artwork and you can move it around. Another great thing that they did is they do have some built-in settings. So if you know that you have a quarter inch wood material, you could click on the built-in settings that they already have in there, or you could also use our tech docs and settings that we have on the web.
And then one other question that came in offline. This particular machine does not require an internet connection, correct? You're connecting your laptop to the laser. You don't have to go through another server or anything like that. Correct?
That's correct. There's a variety of ways you can connect the computer. You can use Wi-Fi, you can use or a wired USB connection. I am using Wi-Fi just because we have multiple people using the lasers here, so it just makes the most sense for me to use it that way. But it does come with a USB cord that you can directly connect it to a computer.
And then and that is a little different than some other similar type lasers that require you to have a internet connection to connect to your servers.
Exactly.
So Evan's pulled out our custom cutout princess here that we have. And if you see, it is, he's peeling the masking off right now. It's a little difficult to peel off sometimes. So we do put masking on both sides of the material, and that helps protect it not only in the laser when you're cutting it so that you're not getting, you know, scorch marks or any type of damage to the material when you're putting it in there, but it also helps protect it when we're shipping it to you and for storage as well, so it's not getting scratched up. See that we've got our princess cut out here. It looks similar to the drawing. And then what we've done is we have used our sublimation printer, and we used our Sawgrass 1000 to print this design that we will be using a heat press to then put it on to our sublimation cast acrylic.
While you're taping that up, I'll explain a little bit about what sublimation is for those of you who may not be familiar. And this is another utility that I think a lot of educators have found has a place in their classroom. A lot of times for, like I mentioned earlier with the cups, making school spirit items or mementos or souvenirs. So sublimation is a printer technology that the ink comes out of the printer, is put onto a transfer sheet. Transfer sheet is then stuck to something that has a receptive coating on it, and then you activate that by putting it inside a press that applies heat and pressure, and that releases the dye into the receptive surface, leaving a permanent color imprint. You probably have sublimation items inside your home right now, don't even know it. Coffee mugs are a really popular item to sublimate onto. A lot of polyester or high polyester shirts that don't have a textured image that you can feel, that's probably also sublimation. Things like leggings and polyester socks are oftentimes sublimation
very
printed too.
Item.
So.
So what we've done here is we've taken our printed transfer, which is the bottom layer here, and then put on top our sublimation cast acrylic, and we've used what's called heat tape. That's what this yellow tape is here. And this tape doesn't melt when heat's applied to it like your typical scotch tape would do. So it is safe to put inside this heat press. And then on our heat press, we have, this is a Teflon pillow cover. This does also come in sheet form as well. But what this does is it protects the platen. So if there's any blowout from the ink, it's not getting onto our platen, and then it won't get onto other items when we sublimate it in the future. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my transfer up onto my Teflon cover here. And then in addition to the Teflon cover, sorry, poor planning, should put this on the other side. We're going to use what is called blowout paper. So this just again protects the heat press here from the ink getting onto either platen. And then the nice feature of this Stahl's Hot Tonics that we're using is it has a pull-out tray. There is a variety of heat presses you can purchase. There are ones that swing away, and there's ones with pull-out trays like this. And so we have our settings in. It's kind of like an oven. We have our temperature set to 360 degrees, and then the time that we're going to essentially cook this transfer in here. So I'm going to slide all of my materials back, and then I'm going to actually shut and clamp the heat press shut. So we've got about 97 seconds for this transfer to go onto our acrylic piece.
And if we have any science teachers on today, they probably know that sublimation is the immediate conversion of a solid to a gas.
That's right.
That's why it's called that. Which is exactly what's going on inside there. The solid ink is being converted into a gas by the heat and pressure and then imprinted onto the acrylic. We had a question.
Yes, well, yes we do. Does this laser come with any chiller or cooling for the tube? It's not really, on this type of a laser, that's not really necessary, is that correct?
Yeah, so with this being, I mean, the Hexa is the most powerful one that we offer. It is a 60 watt. Not really critical on a unit of this size and this power level.
And again, some of the files that we saw, that you've been seeing during the demonstration today, will be available on our page. We're going to have a website page that's going to be launching here soon. We'll send you an email as soon as that's ready to go. Also wanted to give a quick plug while we've got 20 seconds before our angel keychain is done. Check out our YouTube channel at Johnson Plastics Plus on YouTube. We have a lot of videos on the Flux, one that shows you how to use the tumbler attachment, and one that shows you how to use the software as well. So just wanted to give that a go.
Lots of great resources that you guys have been putting on there. I think that's awesome. And really goes a long way to help people get up and running with this equipment.
So the timer went off on our heat press, and you heard that beeping. You do need to be wearing protective gloves, heat gloves, because this is very, very hot when it comes out. So I'm going to take my blowout paper off and then peel my acrylic keychain away from the sublimation paper. And again, it is very hot. Probably should have put two gloves on. I'm not leading by example here, but... So I get it off of here, set it down.
It's okay. She has calluses on her thumbs from doing sublimation work on the regular.
All right. So I'm going to set that down, let it cool here for a minute. Actually, I'll put it on a cool surface.
Yeah. Just to make sure.
Because this is so small, we're going to add a little bit of weight to it. That way it doesn't warp. It is plastic, so it does, you know, like typical plastic, when you heat it up, it could warp a little bit. So we're just adding this, our tape dispenser on top, just to prevent that from happening.
Yep. And while that's cooling off to the touch, she also does have some pieces here to help turn this into a finished keychain, yep, which we'll be able to demonstrate. Is this a good time while we're doing that for me to talk about this?
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
So. You may be watching this and thinking, hey, maybe this is a good fit for us. Obviously, we're happy to help you answer any questions about that as you're considering that for your environment, your school, your classroom. And one of the tools that we often recommend when you get started with this is one of our laser engraving kits. This is something that we recommend to new owners of lasers or potential owners of lasers just to familiarize themselves with what the different products are that can be marked or cut with their laser. So, Caitlin actually got us one of these laser kits. There are multiple of them on our website, packaged with different items that are laser safe. And you can kind of cater that towards your specific interests and what you're looking to get into. So this is an example of the box. There's a lot packed into here.
There's a lot of items. We'll just touch on it pretty quickly here. There is a slate coaster inside of here. So that's another material we didn't really cover here, but it is a slate material, natural material.
Slate looks gorgeous when engraved. It turns kind of a smoky whitish gray. It looks really, really nice when engraved.
It is very cool. We've got some cork. This is a cork trivet that can be laser engraved.
Mm-hmm. We have a set of four bamboo coasters, which look these are very economically priced. They work great as coasters, and they look nice when engraved.
In addition to the coasters, we've provided a small bamboo cutting board so that will engrave similar to the coasters, just a little bit of a bigger material.
And then we have a sheet of, I believe this is birch ply, in here that you can use for cutting and engraving from the laser, very similar to the matching game that we demonstrated. We have, underneath that, we have some of the laser safe rubber for stamps that we demonstrated at the beginning with the book. And we also have several sheets of acrylic. We have cast materials. Yes, George? Go ahead.
Question came in wondering about with the laser, can you laser photos with this lit machine?
Yeah, you definitely can laser photos. It's a really cool process where it kind of similar to the stamp, but it's reversed. So it takes away the background of the photo. We have some examples of that on our website as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that's one of those ones, I think you there are some recommendations as to what you may want to do to the image before you send it to the laser, and I think you could probably pull that off easily in Photoshop, Corel, you know, just to kind of prep the image for that, because you kind of have to simplify it, right? You go from having full color just to taking it down to a few of the details in a monochromatic format. So you kind of have to do a little bit to it, but there are a lot of tutorials and ways to go about that.
A cool way for the art and STEM teachers to come together at the holidays, maybe take photos of the kids, make little ornaments.
There you go.
Yeah.
Love it.
That'd be kind of fun. I was just thinking, I think everybody's getting the George ornament for holidays.
Oh, boy.
Count me in for a George ornament. I'll put you in the best spot on the tree, I promise.
The back of the tree.
There are a lot of sheet materials inside here. So we have some of the 2-ply Romark items, kind of like the locker tags that we talked about. There's a couple different colors of those, some cast acrylic material, and everybody is always hyped about the glitter. I know I am. This is the Color Hues glitter product, and there's one of those included inside the engraving kit. This particular engraving kit as well. There's, again, multiple different options. Are there like 7 or 8 of them on there?
There's 7, yep. Okay. We have 7 kits available. They do fluctuate for the size of the laser. So a lot of the kits have similar materials in it, but if you have a BMO, obviously these size sheets will not fit in that laser. So we've put together kits that when you're purchasing it, you know it's gonna fit into that laser that you have. And one other cool item we'll touch on real quick that it does come with. This is a acrylic light base. So you would use cast acrylic. You could use clear or fluorescent. And I wish I had an example here to show, but the acrylic would slide into the top here, and then it actually, if I put batteries in this, but it actually would light up. So it would glow around the edge of that material. So this is a really cool piece that kids would enjoy seeing their designs come to life with.
Absolutely. And it does run off battery or USB as well.
Yep, with batteries in them.
Yes, you do. So that's just one example of the various laser engraving kits. I think this makes perfect sense to go along with your new laser. That way you can get an example of what products are going to have the best results in your classroom and help you get where you want to be with it.
So our keychain here is cooled down so I can touch it and show you guys how that looks. So you can see how that full color princess that Holt designed really pops with this acrylic. So we did sublimate on the backside of the material, so you can still see the design, but there is some white because that is the sublimation coating. So this keychain is pretty easy to put together. We have this key ring here that will slide through. And then we will put this through. Sorry, hard to do when you're on camera. But so there is our finished keychain. It's a super cool piece that they can take home and show off their drawing or their character that they created.
And what proud parent wouldn't want to carry around a keychain with something their kid drew on it, right? I know I would. That's great. I think that pretty much concludes everything that we wanted to demonstrate for you all today and show. Again, this is the Flux line of lasers. You can learn more about it on jpplus.com. And this webinar will be posted to watch back if you missed anything or want to, you know, pick up on anything else. So. George, any other questions?
Nope, just keep an eye out. We'll be sending an email after with a link to the webinar if you want to watch it again or share it with one of your colleagues. And again, we'll also let you know when we launch that page
with all the artwork,
curriculum and the files on it, and as well as our partners at Flux when they launch theirs as well. So lots of great stuff for STEM, art, any kind of project at schools coming up.
Absolutely, yeah. It truly does dovetail into almost any subject that you could think of in an educating environment. So with that, we thank you so much for watching. I'm Evan with Johnson Plastics.
And I'm Caitlin.
Have a great day.
Thank you.